This is a weed that's directly derived from domesticated rice. And in a way, it's beating us at our own game.
It's been a problem our whole careers. I mean, if I were to come back with this field in a conventional rice next year, then everything that's out there would explode and it would be worse.
A lot of the work that we've done on weedy rice is looking at the evolution of the weed in various parts of the world. And this is a major agricultural problem in rice fields all over the world.
We knew that some technological changes had happened and that weedy rice might have reacted differently than it had for the last 150, 200 years. What we found from those results is that weedy rice that has this herbicide resistance trait is just as resistant as cultivated rice is, just because of this one gene. It means that if you spray herbicide that they don't die and that they remain in the fields and that those are the ones to propagate further, meaning most of their descendants will also be herbicide resistant.
With weedy rice in particular, but really all agricultural weeds, we're really in an arms race.
Given enough time, the weeds are going to win. It's just can you win the battles in between? And know when to throw in the towel and go to another rotational crop or go fallow.
We've got a snapshot now for essentially what the weeds look like very recently compared to what they looked like 20 years ago. They're almost certainly likely to be evolving very quickly as we move forward in the future. I don't know if I would say it's a cautionary tale, but it's certainly predictive of what we're likely to see elsewhere in the world. As herbicide-tolerant rice is grown in other regions, this is the phenomenon that is expected to take place. And so we've been able to document it in real time, and so I expect that this would be the prediction for other parts of the world.